Two friends of Drew Peterson claim their secretly recorded conversations with him may send him to prison.
The Sun-Times reports Paula Stark and Len Wowzak were rewired for sound over the course of 7 months. Wowzak reportedly says he heard Peterson say he should have cremated the body of his third wife, Kathleen Savio. And Wowzak says Peterson predicted that he would have been tried and acquitted by the time the remains of his last wife, Stacy, are found.
Joining us with reaction to the tape conversations is Drew Peterson's attorney, Joel Brodsky. Joel, thanks for joining us.
My pleasure.
This morning. Well, what's your reaction to picking up the paper this morning?
I've learned about this last night, but my reaction is that after all the experience I've had in this business, no way that this happened. The Illinois State Police and the prosecutors would never allow a witness, an undercover witness, for 7 months to talk to the media like this. That would not only be a felony, but would basically throw out all their work for the last 7 months. Mm-hmm. And so I really don't give this much credibility because of that fact. And second of all, you know, Len and Paul are having some financial difficulties. They're being evicted, and they've tried to get some money out of Drew last month. And I think this may be an attempt of them to create a story to sell, as opposed to, you know, try to sensationalize a story.
So some of the things he's saying that in regards to his third wife, Kathleen, I should have had her cremated.
Yeah.
Some of these things. He's denying that the tape even exists, that he ever said any of these
things.
Well,
Drew's reaction when I called him last night to talk to him about this was, his initial reaction was, oh, there's tape me for the last 7 months? Great, because that's going to show I didn't say anything that was incriminating, so that's going to kind of show that I'm innocent. And when I get to the specific statements, he was very adamant that he never said any of these things.
So have you talked to state police? Have they told you that there is indeed a tape?
No, they haven't, and that's a little bit strange also. Under Illinois law, when they have an undercover tape investigation, when it's finished, they have to promptly notify the person who is the subject. We've received no such notification. That, again, makes me believe that this is a fabrication by Len and Paula.
That's a pretty big fabrication to say there's a tape when at some point somebody's going to find out whether there's a tape,
well, yeah,
aren't they?
I agree. Of course, they're really fabricating what's in the tape as opposed to whether or not there is a tape. Drew knows what he said. And Drew knows what his conversations were. And he's confident that if there is a tape, or there are a series of tape conversation, that there's nothing on those tapes like has been said here.
So if this tape does exist, and let's say there are some things that might incriminate your client or might not, is this something that would impact a possible trial, would you, or anything, if charges were brought, would you want the venue changed? What are your thoughts?
Well, absolutely. If there are tapes and there are incriminating statements, obviously that's a problem. Except now what Len and Paul have done, they may have given me ammunition to have any tapes excluded, because the disclosure of this information under state laws is a felony. And if your informants are felons, that right again means that the tape should probably be excluded by the judge is incredible, which is why I'm sure that the Illinois State Police and the prosecutor's office are probably more aggravated about this than I am.
Well, I would imagine there'd be some conversation today.
You'd think. I think because it's either obstruction of justice or a felony a violation of the Wiretap Act, I'm expecting if there's an arrest today, it's probably going to be Len and Paul as opposed to Drew.
Let me ask you, in hindsight, do you think it would have been better advice to Drew Peterson to just keep his mouth shut and not do Today Show interviews and all this? I mean, how is that an advantage to you guys?
Well, I mean, that's a different subject than this.
It may or may not be, depending on
Drew can't be accused in this particular case of doing. We had nothing to do with the newspaper this morning. It was unrelated to us at all. As far as our strategy of talking to the media, we've decided in consultation with other people that in a high-profile case like this, that unless you get out there and talk to some extent and engage the media, that it's actually negative, that you really need to do it in an extreme high-profile case like this, where in a less high-profile case you might not want to.
What is Drew doing in the search for Stacy?
Well, the only thing we've done is through the private investigators trying to find her electronically, you know, on the grid, as they say, through their search methods. Drew doesn't have the money, you know, to send somebody to Thailand or to, you know, Georgia or wherever to try to find Stacy, because, you know, he's limited in a resource. But what we have been able to do is get a couple of private investigators through their techniques and seeing if they can find her. And obviously, up to now, we've been unsuccessful.